In a previous video, I shared with you how some longevity experts and health span experts are using the practice of hyperbaric oxygen and hypoxia to cause the release of stem cells from your body, and how that can actually improve not only energy levels, but also improve self-regulation and activate homeostasis and so on. There are many ways to activate stem cells, but I have also mentioned in the past how Kumbhaka, the practice of breath retention, could do the same. So, is there any logic to this? And is there any research? And the answer is yes. And the practice of breath retention in pranayama, Kumbhaka, has potential links to stem cell activation. Research suggests that intermittent hypoxia, which can be induced by certain forms of breath retention, and I mentioned one that I do, the crow's breath, 6, 12, 12, 6 cycle. That's something I do, 2 breaths per minute to activate stem cells and stem cell release. But there's a practice called Nishesha Recheka Pranayama that facilitates stem cell mobilization from the bone marrow to the tissues. This occurs because brief hypoxic conditions can alter oxygen levels in the bloodstream, creating a favorable environment for stem cell release. Additionally, stress signals and changes in the bone marrow microenvironment are known to mobilize hematopoietic stem cells. And practices like Kumbhaka may indirectly influence these mechanisms by promoting physiological stress responses or reducing oxygen and nitric acid levels. So this is already part of ongoing research. Now, I know many of you who are watching this are going to say, so what is this Nishesha Recheka Pranayama? So Nishesha Recheka Pranayama is a yogic breathing technique that emphasizes complete exhalation and breath retention at residual lung volume. Residual lung volume means when all lungs are empty of all air. The term Nishesha Recheka translates to complete exhalation, and the practice involves holding the breath after fully exhaling to max. This induces a state of brief intermittent hypoxia, lower than normal oxygen levels in the blood, which has been linked to various physiological and therapeutic benefits. Here are the key features of this practice. The practitioner fully exhales fully, emptying the lungs as much as possible. That's number one. Two, breath retention. After exhalation, the breath is held for a short duration, creating a state of emptiness in the lungs. And three, intermittent hypoxia. The controlled hypoxic state activates adaptive responses in the body. Here are the physiological benefits. Enhances lung function and oxygen utilization. Number one, stimulates erythropoietin production, increasing red blood cell count. Number three, mobilizes stem cells from bone marrow to tissues, aiding in repair and regeneration. And four, boosts nitric oxide production, which protects against oxidative damage. So there are many therapeutic benefits. Number one, improved resistance to injuries and aging-related damage. Number two, reduction of inflammation. Strengthens immunity, lowers blood pressure. Number three, supports healing processes by enhancing vascular endothelial growth factor activity. vascular endothelial growth factor, VEGF activity. Number three, mental and spiritual benefits. Induces relaxation by activating the parasympathetic nervous system and enhances focus and mindfulness through meditative states. Now, just a word of precaution, Nishesha Rechaka Pranayam should be practiced under expert guidance, somebody who teaches yoga and pranayam. By the way, that's how I learned it. And it's especially if you're having respiratory or cardiovascular conditions, then please do not overdo it, but always do it under supervision, because overdoing it can lead to dizziness and discomfort due to prolonged hypoxia. This ancient technique demonstrates how controlled breathwork can harness the body's natural healing mechanisms while promoting physical, mental, and spiritual well-being. Let me know if you found this interesting. And of course, please feel free to share it with your friends. Thank you.